what are these energy transitions and what do they look like? Well, we've got historical precedent for this, and we can go back and look at these two big energy transitions that have occurred in the past to form a view of what the future is going to look like too. So the first big energy transition is coal. 1750, the world's energy mix is about 90% burning wood and horses and oxen pulling carts, right? It's not a particularly advanced energy system. And then over this period of 80 years, from 1830 onwards, coal really starts building into the mix. And this is the first great energy transition. It takes 80 years, as I said, and we still burn twice as much wood as coal in the 19th century as this is happening. At the same time, coal creates all these new sources of demand like steamboats and mechanization and railways. That's what the first one looks like. The second one looks eerily similar. So it's oil. Oil starts really building into the mix from about 1910 onwards. Oil peaks the share of the world's energy mix in 1973. Again, a 60-year transition. And just in the same way, we burned 15% more coal than oil in the 20th century. And oil unlocked these unimaginable new sources of demand that nobody could have seen coming, like plastics and planes and cars. So here we are in 2019, and it looks like we're going to have an energy transition, but actually we're not. We're going to have five energy transitions all at the same time. These are happening right now. And I think that analogy of what the past looks like is really applicable here. I think it's also going to take 70 plus years to meaningfully shift the energy system. And I think it's also going to create new sources of demand and opportunities that are just beyond imagination today. And so let's go into that. So what are these five great energy transitions? Number one, renewables. The price of wind and solar has come down by 90% since the 1980s. If you go out and fill your car up with oil today at the pump, you pay 100 cents per kilowatt hour for energy. Okay, wind and solar on average are adding kilowatt hours to the grid at about 5 cents a kilowatt hour. They are the bottom of the cost curve, and they're gonna scale up and reshape the entire energy landscape over the next century. Energy transition number two, shale. So for the first 150 years of oil, we've been getting this resource from conventional reservoirs. These are sandstones and carbonates that are porous and permeable. Now, for the last decade, we haven't been reliant on getting oil out of these reservoir rocks. We're going straight to the source rock where the oil is generated. And this is transformational. There's 10 times more oil in these source rocks than in the reservoirs. And the technology just keeps getting better and better. I recently went back through 300 technical papers in shale. 100 of them are going to improve productivity. On my numbers, shale is going to be capable of reaching 25, 30 million barrels a day. And to a lot of people, that's going to sound crazy, but I can take you through some of that. And these technologies coming through, they're just game changers. Energy transition number three, electrification. So if you are driving a fossil fuel car today, you get 18% conversion efficiency of the gasoline in the tank to useful energy you can drive with. Make that car an electric car, and you're at 70%. So the solution here is you want to electrify as much of this inefficient combustion process as possible. And again, that is going to go and apply to as many machines as possible over the next few decades. This is why you see oil majors trying to get into the electricity business. This is the future. Energy transition number four, digital. So it's really easy to think of an oil platform as an oil platform as an oil platform. But the ones being built today from an engineering perspective are light years ahead of the platforms of the past. You go out to the North Sea today to a modern instrumented oil platform, and it has 60,000 tags on 60,000 pieces of equipment relaying data back to shore in real time. If something is about to break, you can see that it's about to break before it breaks and stop it breaking. This is yielding OPEX per barrel of $3 to $4 on these next generation platforms. And it's sweeping through the whole industry. Energy transition number five, the big kahuna, carbon. The world is putting 35 billion tons of carbon out into the atmosphere every year. And we've got to change that. And the oil companies know we've got to change that. In fact, you could go so far as to say, nobody is more interested in driving this energy transition than big oil. Because if they don't, they are not going to have a license to operate. And really, in the last few years, you've seen companies embrace that message, hook, line, and sinker. These companies know they've got to change and they want to deliver this transition. So let's recap. Here are the five themes: renewables, shale, digital, electrification, and environmental. And really, all of these just are enormous uncertainties for investors. And that is why, without an understanding of these uncertainties, it is so hard to open your wallet to this industry. And that is the whole point of why I want to do what I'm doing, which is help investors see the opportunities in technology. Because, you know, we need to rebuild not the energy system that we have so far, but three or four more of these things. And we just aren't going to do it unless the capital can go in. So the latest numbers from the IEA, I mentioned the world invested $1.85 trillion in energy last year. We need to increase that by $200-300 billion per annum by the 2020s in order to meet the world's energy needs. There are opportunities there. Unless investors can see those opportunities, it's not going to happen, and we've got to change that.